In today's video, I'll show you how to create a little pop of whimsy for your garden, whether you've got a large planting bed or a balcony flower pot. It's time to treat your plants to a little gift. Let's get to it. Welcome back. And if you're new here, my name is Julie. And on this channel, we discuss tips, tricks, tools, adhesives, materials, and specific mosaic projects, all to shorten your learning curve when it comes to creating mosaic art. So if that sounds like something you'd be interested in, please consider subscribing. Whether you're a full-time gardener or a hobbyist like me, it's fun to see art in the garden, especially mosaic art. Am I right? The softness and variety of colors mixed with the hard materials of mosaic give the eye so much to look at when out in the garden. It's like searching for treasure. I've always enjoyed being in a garden that is full of art and adornments and figures mixed in with the plants. Today, I'm going to show you how to create your own mosaic garden stake. And the nice thing about this project is you can decide what size shape you want your garden stake to be, how high you want it to be displayed, or how low. It's totally customizable. I'll be using VD board as the substrate in today's project. And if you'd like to see how I cut VD board, I'll put a link here in the description card as well as down below so you can check it out. So as I mentioned, I've already cut down my VD board in a previous video, and so my VD board is ready for the next step. The VD board I'm using in today's project is 1/2 inch thick. It does come in 1/8 to 2 inch thickness. I'll tile the whole stake, the front, the back, and the sides. I'm gonna have a specific design on the front, and I'm gonna have uncut tile on the back. These stakes will be displayed in my garden where nobody will really see the back, but I do wanna finish off the entire surface area. I'll include a list with links down below in case you're interested in creating your own mosaic garden stake. We've got a lot to cover, so let's get started. When deciding how big you should cut your substrate, there are a few things you want to keep in mind. Where will you display your garden stake? Will it be in a garden or will it be in a flower pot? Also, how thick is your VD board? And the size of your rod will be decided by how thick a VD board you have. If you have a really big garden stake, then obviously you're going to need a thicker rod to support the weight of that garden stake. But also, if you do make a bigger garden stake, that garden stake might need to be displayed a little closer to the ground depending on the thickness of your rod. A thinner rod can't support the thickness and weight of a larger garden stake. The rods I'm using today are made out of aluminum. They're pretty substantial. They're not gonna bend easily. After you've made those decisions and you've cut down your VD board, you're ready to prep the sides of your piece, which are the exposed sides where you can see the blue foam. The first step is to cover the exposed foam edges with self-adhesive fiberglass tape. You might want to put on some disposable gloves when handling it. Just center it over the exposed foam and fold it down on both sides. Make sure you cover your corners if your piece has any. The second step is to insert the metal rod into the foam core of your VD board. And as I mentioned earlier, the rod I'm using is made out of aluminum. Now, depending on the shape and design of your piece, you might be inserting your rod into the bottom or the side of your substrate. You might need to cut a small hole into the mesh tape to get things started because the adhesive is strong and it's doing its job of sticking to the foam core. Now, you're probably wondering how far you should insert the rod, and that's subjective. You can only go so far before the foam will break. I'm gonna insert the rod about halfway through the substrate at the most. If you want, you can always measure it out and put a mark on your rod so you know exactly how far to go. The third step is to cover the surface of both sides of the beady board and fiberglass mesh tape with a thin coat of thinset mortar. I'm using a charcoal gray thinset because I'm going to be using a grout in the same color. If you're going to be using a lighter colored grout on your garden stake, then use a white thinset mortar. If you're curious how I mix up small batches of thinset mortar, I'll put a link here in the description card as well as down below, and you'll want to go to the thinset mortar chapter of that video. You'll want to smooth on a thin coat of the mortar on the front and the back and the sides, and even where the rod meets the foam core. I like to put a little bit in the opening and then put the rod in, and just that little bit of cement, it's just a little bit of reinforcement. So there's cement on the inside and then there's cement on the outside where the rod meets the foam. And then you'll want to let it dry for at least 24 hours before you start tiling. I've already picked out the materials and I've sketched the design directly onto the substrate using a piece of chalk. The substrates have been sitting here at least 24 hours and now I'm ready to get tiling. And yes, I decided to make two of them. The adhesive for this project is fortified mortar, and that's the same material we use to cover the surface area of the VD board. It's easy to work with, it's durable, and it's gonna give your mosaic longevity when out in the elements. If you don't have a design in mind and you just want to tile and see what comes to you, that's okay. Or, like what I did, you can draw your design directly onto the substrate. Okay, I'm going to get started with tiling. Well, they're both done. I'm going to let them sit here for at least 24 hours before I grout. And as I mentioned earlier, I chose a grout color that matched the thinset mortar. So I'm going with charcoal gray grout. If you'd like to see how I mix up small batches of grout, I'll put a link here in the description card as well as down below, and you'll want to go to the grouting chapter of that video. It's important to mention that because we're creating a mosaic that's going to go outdoors, you should be using fortified grout. And if your grout is not labeled as fortified, you can easily add a latex additive, which looks just like this, and you're going to use that instead of water. It's going to give your mosaic longevity, It's going to help prolong the life of your mosaic, and it's going to keep the color of your grout looking vibrant. Okay, my grout has been sitting here for about 5 minutes, so now I'm ready to get started. And I'll just put a little bit on, and I'll do the clockwise, counterclockwise motion, pushing it into the grout line in between the tile and the glass, in between the tile and the stained glass. I'm just gonna work my way around clockwise, counterclockwise, just keep going. Make sure you have enough grout on your surface to push into the areas between your pieces. And obviously, you wanna get around the rod as well as the pieces. While I'm grouting, I've actually got the rod up against my forearm and an elbow. And it's helping to bear some of the weight of the piece and also keep it stable, keep it from getting away from me so much. And once you're done grouting, you're gonna let it sit for at least 10 minutes so it can start drying, and then we'll come back and start cleaning it off. And we wait. The garden stakes have been sitting here drying, and now they're ready to be cleaned off. If you've been around these parts long enough, you know that I like to use dry paper towels instead of bringing more moisture to the piece. I'm going to remove the grout in the same way that I applied it, which is clockwise and counterclockwise motions, just to clean off the surface area, do an initial cleaning. And yes, sometimes you do need to use a damp sponge to get the grout off. My first choice in a situation like this, especially a small mosaic like this, is to use a dry paper towel. So I'm just gonna do a quick initial cleaning off, and then I'll go back and polish up. They're both grouted, and I'm so happy with how they turned out. To give your mosaic more longevity when kept outdoors, you can apply a grout sealer, but you'll want to wait at least 3 days after grouting before you do that. If you'd like to learn more about grout sealers, I'll put a link here in the description card as well as down below, and you'll want to go to the grout sealer chapter of that video. To ensure that your garden stake lasts throughout the seasons, you may want to bring it indoors during harsher weather conditions. I hope you enjoyed creating a mosaic garden stake. They're such a treat in the garden, and they just add a little pop of color, whether your garden is blooming or maybe it's a dormant season. But they're a lot of fun, and they're a great creative way to bring in a little pop of color into your garden. Question of the day, let me know in the comments if you've ever created mosaic garden art. I'd love to hear. Thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up, as it really does help my channel, and subscribe if you haven't already. Click the bell notification so you never miss a single upload, and let me know in the comments if there's something you'd like me to cover in a future video. I'll see you soon. Bye. Why is this so hard to say? It's so hot. Summertime is here. Goodness gracious. Oh my goodness gracious. No, is that right? Aluminum. Nope, we're getting to that later on. And yes, I decided to make two. Oh, it's doing so good there. Ooh, Amazon. If you're looking for more mosaic inspiration, you can check out one of these two videos. Until then, see ya.